Hey everybody, today is September 8th and it's the Feast of the Nativity of the Theotokos. Today is one of the major feast days of the Orthodox Church. And what's really interesting is that the Orthodox Church calendar year starts with its first major feast of the birth of the Theotokos and ends in August with the feast of the death of the Theotokos, the falling asleep or dormition of the Theotokos. So in essence, the ecclesiastical year, the whole cycle of the church's calendar revolves around and is bookended by the birth and the death of the Theotokos. And today's readings and our feast hymns remind us of the importance of the Virgin Mary in the life of the church and in that the fact that Jesus took flesh from this woman who was born today of Joachim and Anna. So let's look a little bit at what the church believes and understands about this event. The first thing is that the Virgin Mary's parents were named Joachim and Anna. This is not something that appears in scripture, but is something that is held within the tradition of the Orthodox Church and other writings of the early church. Now, Joachim and Anna were barren. They had not been able to have children. And just like Saint Hannah did in age before, as we talked about in our video on the prophet Samuel, and just like Zechariah and Elizabeth did when they were not able to have a child and then they were able to bear Saint John the Baptist, they prayed and they were people of prayer and the Lord answered their prayers and they were able to conceive the Virgin Mary. Now this is the event that we celebrate today, and what's really beautiful is that today we're celebrating the birth of the Virgin Mary and tomorrow we celebrate those who made today possible. So today we celebrate her birth, therefore tomorrow we celebrate Joachim and Anna as the parents without whom we would not have the Virgin Mary today. And therefore we have the genealogy of the Theotokos and of Christ. We have Jesus, the son of Mary, the son of Anna, the daughter of Mary. And this is really beautiful that we have this maternal line of Jesus, of whom he comes in the flesh. Now, our readings today come from Philippians chapter 2 and Luke chapter 10 and 11. And both of these readings in some way really are talking about Christ, because remember, whenever we talk about the Virgin Mary, her importance in the life of the church is because of her role in bringing forth the Savior. So our reading from Philippians 2 says, Christ, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men. And then it says that he humbled himself and became obedient even unto death. This is a reminder that Jesus existed before all ages, that Jesus, as the second person of the Holy Trinity, is God. And then he became flesh, he took on flesh and became a human being, fully God and fully man, through the Virgin Mary. So without the Virgin Mary being born today, Jesus wouldn't have been able to take flesh from her and become man. So we have this reading today as a reminder of the fact that Jesus became human truly and humbled himself completely and emptied himself for our salvation. And the reading from the Gospel of Luke is a story about Martha and Mary. And then at the very end of it, there's this person in the crowd that shouts out, you know, he says, blessed is the womb that bore you and the breast that you sucked. And so acknowledging, wow, this person, Jesus, is this very important person. He must be coming from a really blessed and special woman. And Jesus responds, blessed rather are those that hear the word of God and keep it. And sometimes people would say, oh, look, this is evidence that Jesus was saying, don't focus on his mother. He wasn't saying that. He would never have said anything against his mother. He is simply saying, yes, she is blessed, but blessed are those people who hear the word of God and keep it. In other words, don't just focus on this, but focus on the doing of what she also did as well. So this is what we're called to do today. On the Feast of the Nativity of the Theotokos, we are called to follow in the footsteps of those that came before us, just in the same way that Jesus followed in the footsteps of his mother, who followed in the footsteps of her mother and father, who walked in the footsteps of her mother and father. And we're called to follow in the footsteps of our mother, the Virgin Mary, the Theotokos, as we celebrate her birth, and then tomorrow, as we celebrate Joachim and Anna. I pray that they will continue to pray for all of us and inspire us to pursue the Lord and to not only hear the law and the word of God, but to do it. Amen.